Hi, it's Mike with AskTractorMike.com. This is going to be kind of a fun video today, and I'd like your input because I'm going to ask you about stuff that you find out in your fence row. And I'm in my fence row today. This is where I put stuff. It's out of sight. It's back in the back of the woods. I have old pallets that are kind of rotting down. I have an old trampoline that I bent when I was moving it. I have some old concrete blocks on a pallet that's about rotted out. Also, I have an old swing set right in back of me, and a couple of implements, a box blade, and a rock rake back here. So this is my fence row that no one knows is here and no one can see. And if I moved from this place, part of this stuff I'd leave for the next guy to deal with. But that's what we're going to talk about today is fence row finds. And most of us that have moved to the country have bought property from somebody else. And I would say most of the time, there'll be something out there that you find that they've left that was too expensive to move or not worth the hassle to move. And my first question today is, what's the weirdest thing you ever found? You know, like old tillage equipment, old brush hogs, old blades, and were you able to bring them back to life and were you able to use them? That's question number one. Question number two is, what would you do if you were Timothy? And I got an email from Timothy, and this is kind of a Tractor Mike Q&A. And Timothy bought new property and found an old brush hog sitting in the mud about 4 inches deep or so. And none of the decals are legible to read, and the top is rusted out, and the gearbox is free and still spins. And it looks like it has all the parts there. And I'm trying to see if I will be able to use it on my John Deere 850. But since I don't know what brand it is or type of gearbox, I don't know how to find specs on it. Well, I'm going to show you pictures of Timothy's find. And boy, she's a jewel. He described it accurately. But I corresponded with him. I said, well, why do you need the specs on it? And I think he's just wanting to know if it'll fit the tractor. And yeah, I think it will. It's an older, cheaper cutter. He says everything works like it should. I've only rotated the gearbox by the PTO shaft by hand, and it spins the blades. He hooked up the three-point to move it since it was stuck in 3 inches of mud, and the tail wheel was free also. Of course, the metal on the top is rusted all the way through, and the gearbox, it had a little plate on it maybe that's gone, but it has a number one casted into the back of the gearbox. So, first off here, does anybody know what brand this is? Help Timothy out. I don't think, it's hard to say what kind of brush hog this is. If you ever need parts for it, it's likely going to be a gearbox. And lots of times, there's places online that you can go and where our parts guys at the dealership I worked with would go, and they would look up if they had a gearbox, if they could cross-reference it with other gearboxes. It's less important whoever made the brush hog than who made the components that went with the brush hog. A lot of these older brush hogs, you know, they welded up the frame, and that was made in the factory, and they put their brand name on it. But the gearbox they bought from somebody else, and that's the part that is hard to replace. So it's a good chance if you blew up the gearbox, you could find a replacement gearbox. But this cutter's in such bad shape, if you blow up anything on it, I think it's just going to be scrap. I wouldn't spend, you know, you're probably going to spend, you know, $400, $500 maybe on putting a replacement gearbox on. So I wouldn't go there. I would just run it till it blows. Now, I would check, make sure there's oil in the gearbox, and my guess is it's going to be milky oil. It's probably got water in it. It may be mostly water. Drain that oil out, put new oil in. Even before I did that, I would lift it up with the three-point of the tractor, put some jack stands under it, and check the blade pan. Make sure the blades, you know, the pan that holds the blades is not rusted out or the bolts are not rusted out. If you kick in the PTO and you send a blade out, it could go into your tractor tire or your dog or whatever, and make sure no one is around when you do that. And then if you get serious about using it, you'll probably want to weld some plate on top of it to keep debris from coming up from the bottom when you're cutting with it. That'll make it safe. You know, it's an old beater brush hog, and you know, if I had property I didn't know, I'd rather tear up something like that than a new one. So I'd hook it up and use it. I'm an old cheap farm kid. I'd make it work and see what happened. But I'm curious to see comments about what would you do if you had Timothy's brush hog. Would you use it or would you scrap it and get a new one? Last question, and this is personal. Timothy made me think of something I have not thought about in 20 years. When I was a kid, I grew up on an apple orchard, and my dad had what was called a culta cutter. and it was a device that had teeth that went down in the ground, and the whole machine rested on this row of teeth. I say teeth. They had four lobes on them, and it's just beat the ground to a pulp and break up the fescue sod, and it was called a culta cutter. And I have Googled it. I have looked all over the internet. I've never seen another one. And the only reason I thought about it, because it rested on these teeth. It was a row of teeth like this, about that wide, and they would go in the ground, and the whole machine rested on those teeth, and it would just beat the sod up. And we used it in the orchard to try to beat the sod up around trees to kill off the fescue sod so it wouldn't compete with the tree roots. I don't think it worked very good, but I remember Dad as a kid with an old Oliver 70 tractor going around and around these new trees that were planted with this culta cutter. Well, after a few years, we decided that wasn't working very good, so we parked it, and because it rested on these teeth, as it sat, it would sink into the ground. So we towed it to the back of the woods and parked it, and it's been there for probably 40 years now. And I'm the only human alive that knows it's back there and knows what it is. My question to you, if you're an old guy, then maybe you know, what was a culta cutter? I'm curious. I cannot find it I don't know if it's culta, C-U-L-T-A. I don't know if there's a hyphen. I don't know if it's C-U-L-T-I. But I'd be curious if any of my viewers have ever heard of a culta cutter. I'm just curious. Appreciate you watching my videos. Here's a couple more that YouTube thinks you might be interested in. And if you'd like to subscribe to my YouTube channel, I'd be honored. Click the mic face icon and make sure you check the bell so you're notified when I post videos. Thanks for watching.